I'm just speaking. All those people that was around Jesus, how many of them needed something from him? Every one of them. She was so determined to get what she needed, she reached into the heaven. Listen, first of all, she shouldn't have been there. Secondly, she had been bleeding for 12 years. You know she was weak.
Yes, sir.
Sisters, you know when you have a cycle, y'all get crazy. Oh, not this. Y'all going to get off.
Church, okay. Wait a minute.
Y'all come on, get off. You know what I mean? Y'all got some real issues. So, ain't no man no good. Ain't no man worth the difference. I'm talking about me first. I know. I've been told that I was no good. I need to leave the house. I want a divorce. I've been told all of that, but and then I stay. Something had to be wrong with me. Look at me. I feel like someone, why am I taking this verbal? Anyway, you could not imagine how weak she was, sister. Y'all know. Imagine how weak she was. And then the Bible says, she pressed her way through. She said, no. It didn't say that she was on her knees, but to reach down and touch somebody, hem of a garment, which was a robe, that she had to be on her hands and knees. An act of surrenderance to him. I don't care what I have to do. All I want to do is touch the hem. I don't need to touch him. Remember in the book of Acts, they said his shadow, need a shadow, just overshadowing them was healed. See, when you're anointed of God, everything you have on is anointed. They don't have to. You don't have to lay hands on them. Just right by Sister Ruby. Get a touch. The Bible says, when she touched him, immediately, not 2 days later, not 10 minutes later, it said immediately, her issue was dried up. 12 years. Can you imagine, sister? We don't have a clue. So I ain't going to even address this to the brothers. Because they don't have a clue. They just like me, don't have a clue. But what I read, and I ain't going to raise that because I've been saying something got slapped. So we don't have a clue of what that feels like. Our idea. Women do have an idea of how draining that would have to be. Sisters, I appreciate God making y'all the way y'all are because I couldn't.
Yes, Lord.
Because all men probably would be dead. Come on. I just walk around shooting. Every time I look at the cross, I pop. What you looking at? After I shoot. Shoot first. But see, the Bible says, and I understand what I'm saying. Anytime you get on your knees, it's an act of surrendering.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Yes,
sir. I'm surrendering to you, God, and all I want to do is to touch. Listen, I can see her pushing. They're so busy being in the presence of Jesus. They ain't worried about what's going on underneath. They ain't trying to touch and get what they need. See, if I could just... it's all right. This is my wife. I can touch the hem of her garment. That's my wife. So I'm going to tell her to touch my somebody's wife. That's my wife. I touched the heavenly garden, and the Bible said immediately she was made whole.
Yes, sir.
The Bible said, Bishop Campbell preached it, they said at midnight, Paul and Silas praying and singing praises and worships to God. And it said immediately an earthquake came. And shut all the bands off. Are everybody in prison? See, when you're not selfish and you're praying for everybody else, God will loose them. There's a loosening in this place.
Amen. Yes, God.
They wasn't praying because, and then after they come out, and the guy was going to kill himself. And Paul said, hey man, don't kill yourself. Ain't nobody left.
Yeah.
And when they came to let Paul out the next morning, nobody told him, I ain't going nowhere. Y'all publicly beat me. I want to publicly.
Be quiet.
If they let y'all, they go. It'll be like Paul. Under the main market right there. Better go and take that freedom. I'm out of here, Paul. You just stay if you want to. I'm gone. But see, Paul, expectations reached into heaven and pulled down what God had for them. Him and Silas. See, what does it say? Where two or three touch and agree. Husband and wife, boyfriend and girlfriend, make sure you touch it and agree. Sisters and brothers, yes, and mother well, touch and agree.
Amen.
I call them because I love them. They are right. Me and my wife, I just take oil. She ain't got no grease. When I all that oil I put on her. She be slide. But I be agreeing with her in the spirit realm. See, I don't take it for lightly. For so long God said, we're taking it too lightly. We come into church with no expectations. Our expectations are so low. And I want you to reach to heaven. Everything you say, I want to go to heaven and pull it back. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come in the earth as it is in heaven. He said, I'm going to let my will, that what's going on in the heavenly,
come down here.
Yeah. No sickness in heaven.
Yeah.
Ain't no unforgiveness in heaven.
Amen.
There's love. There's joy. See, at Sunday school this morning, everybody get in this Sunday school thing. Boy, they just like talking. They start getting carried away. They just go on and on. It gets so good, man. I start sitting there being quiet. But I had to remind them, you got 45 minutes. The Bible says God does everything decently in order.
Amen.
So everything has to be done. And God is what God is doing now. He's raising everyone's expectations to a high level. You know you're not where you should be. You know you're not where you need to be. All of us in here know that. None of us exist, but God is doing it today. He's speaking something special over our lives. Listen. When you go home, don't get mad at your husband. Don't be mad at your husband. This bread is just be tough down his throat. Push it. Put your tongue down his throat.
Mm-mm. Mm-mm.
Damn. Y'all laughing, huh?
Yeah, it's too close.
Sure, honey, I can admit.
Too close.
Oh, my God.
God is here.
Amen.
I ain't saying his name in my kitchen. Stop laughing. We're raising our expectation to a higher level. See, so I know I've been married. I said, tell them to pray for me. I take that oil they got in their pocket. They won't miss it to pray for a poor woman. One of the two. But I'm telling you, God didn't expect it. Listen, you don't have to continue to live like you're living. Whatever you need, if you need finances,
yes.
God has it.
Amen.
He said, I go prepare a place for you. Mm-hmm. See, when you get to heaven, you got matches. What? If you said in heavenly principle to the earth realm, why can't I have a mansion down here?
Amen.
Streets of gold. Man, I'd like to have a house full of gold. A staircase full of just gold walking up there. Every time I need a little bit, I break a little bit off. I have an ounce off and take it to the store. I know. Wouldn't that be nice, would it? Don't have to rely on. See, let me show you how God works. God's intention was never for man to work.
I get home. Can
look at the Old Testament. Study it. There was some honor system.
Can I play?
Sister Tasha grew green. I had chicken.
That's right.
I trade.
Yeah.
And if I didn't, she didn't give me enough on the trade, but when she turned her back, I just take her. Go give me a handful of the collard greens. But that's what God's intention. That's why we are frustrated on God. You should open your own business. Some of you, God has spoken to my businesses, and you're afraid to step out on faith. Because you said, Lord, is that you or is that me? They say, try the Spirit by the Spirit. Spirit is the Spirit of God.
Yeah.
You get to. Our expectation is not high enough. Oh, I don't know what the God wants me. Listen, when I'm on my business, on my own business, I'm my own boss. So nobody can tell me when to come to work.
Amen.
Nobody can tell me how long I have to work. I work according to my needs. That's what I do. If I need some extra money, I work harder. If I don't, I stay at home. I go home and work 3 or 4 hours. Ride a line, call Sister Brother, give her a hard time by walking the dog. Sister Brother walks the dog every day. But see, y'all laughing. Walking the dog pays. I walk the dog if they pay me. A lady say, Sister Salt, don't come back here killing my dog. Say, Salt walk the dog so long that the dog comes and the dog old. She walked that up. I didn't bring that one. I just added to it. Walk the dog so my dog tongue hang out. That's 100 degrees. You can't walk on a dog like that.
Well, I don't know.
You'll know next time. But anyway, listen. God says, listen. Let your expectation level rise.
Yeah.
Listen, it's time for some of you to get out and start ministry. And start sitting here Sunday after Sunday. People ask me, come and speak. Oh, I don't speak well. So what? Moses didn't either.
Baby, come here.
When the anointing of God get on you, I've seen stutterers never stutter.
That's right.
I know a brother from Bethel Temple. I said all the time, I ain't talking to him. I said, man, listen, I ain't got no 30 minutes to complete going one sentence. Y'all know I'm like that. Now. Y'all know that's my person. Why are you looking at me like you're mad? Listen, he takes 30 minutes to get one sentence out. I'm frustrated. I'm real. I said, John, hold it. Write it down on a piece of paper. And then I can give it to him and I'll read it. John, please write it down. And he get mad. What you get mad at? This is my time. Only thing God gave us control over, Chicago, was our time. So I'm not going to waste your time. What time is Sunday school start?
9.
What time is Sunday school over?
9. 9:40.
What time church start?
10.
If you get in after 10, you're what?
Late.
So your expectation ain't too high. No, I didn't take that back. I just said that. Anyway, but God said, raise it up. And if you got a wife, man, you always going to be late. Listen, your expectation got to just keep rising higher and higher. But you love that son, Richard. It's got to keep rising higher and higher. So Bishop Campbell don't have to say, kind of push and fire us every Sunday about coming with expectations on our hearts.
Yes, God.
Come. Expecting God to do something for me every time I enter. When I go on my knees every night, I expect God to do something for me. Every time I pick up the word of God, I expect God to do something. Deliver me from evil. And the more God reach down into your deeper, more inner man and pull all that trash that we have deep within us that we try to hold on to. Listen, it was 20 years before God delivered me from my dead dad. Still harboring on you. Daddy put me out in 10th grade. Out in the house. Couldn't even go stay with my own cousin. He wouldn't let none of them, he let me in. Don't tell me. And God still carried me through because he had purpose on my life. All that we've been through, God still got purpose on my life. And we're not stepping up and meeting his expectations through his word. He expects us to go out and do. He said, go out in the highways and byways and compel men to come. Listen, the word compel in the Greek means literally grab them in the collar. I grab you in the collar, you'll be ready to fight. I look at me crazy, y'all, but you got to be on the road. See, but that's because of the relationship I established with you. You don't mind me correctly. But you got to establish a relationship. You can't go grab nobody in the collar, ain't got no relationship. I grab you in the collar, you're going to pull out your razor. I know you got a razor in your mouth. And then you got to wipe it all over and get outside and leave. All the cup. See, my daddy's always careful now. So, but I'm just saying, God is expecting us to rise up. Listen to me. Listen to me carefully. If you want to rise up to a higher expectation place, come on, I'm going to pray in the church and agree with you. God is expecting it. God knows where your heart is. Come on up here. Come on.